Hello friends and welcome to Virtual Tech Box YouTube channel. In today's video I will show you how to create the custom Windows 10 ISO, or you can say how to create the bootable ISO of the Windows 10 running system. You can use this method for creating the bootable ISO of any Windows running system, whether it is Windows Server 2019, Windows 10 or Windows 8 or Windows 2016. Let's start. This is my Lenovo laptop having Windows 10 installed in it. I will go to run and I will type cmd enter. This is the user, local user through which I have logged into my Windows 10 system. The first step, we have to run the sysprep. For that I will go to run, I will type here the percent windir percent backslash system 32 backslash sysprep backslash sysprep dot exe space forward slash audit space forward slash reboot, and once I hit the OK, it will reboot my system and it will take me to the default local administrator account. I will press OK here. Sysprep is working. It is now restarting my Windows 10 system. Sysprep has brought us to the default local administrator account. I will provide the password for the administrator. You can see here sysprep windows is already open. At this step we have to delete all the user accounts except local administrator account. For that I will go to start and I will search the control panel. Small icons. I will go to user accounts, manage other accounts. This is my user account. I will select this and I will select the delete files, delete account, user account has been deleted from my system and only local administrator account is present. I will close this. Now we have to run the disk cleanup. For that I will go to run and I will type here clean mgr and I will press the OK. I will select the C drive. OK, and here we can select all the unwanted files which we want to delete, log files, downloaded program files, and here you can delete the older version of Windows also if it is available in your system. I will select all those unwanted files which I want to delete. Okay. I will confirm to delete files. Disk cleanup is working. It will now delete all the unwanted files from my system, from my C drive, whichever I had selected. Disk cleanup has completed. Now on the sysprep window, in the first drop down, I will select the inter system out of box experience, and I will tick the generalize and here I will drop down and select the shutdown. I will press the OK. Now sysprep will be executed and it will shut down my system. I will power on my system. I will set my region. Yes. I will select my keyboard layout. Yes. Accept. I will select my Wi-Fi network. I will enter the password for the Wi-Fi. Connect. Next. Setup for personal use. Next, offline account, limited experience. I will provide my username here. Next, I will set the password for my username. Next, I will confirm the password here. Next, I will type the hint here for my password. Next, skip for now. Yes, accept. We have now successfully logged into our account which we have recently created. At this stage, you can create all the users whichever you want in your system. Just do the login logout once in your user. Install all the required software in the system whichever you want. Update your Windows to the latest patches. I will go to run. I will type here cmd. Okay, this is the username through which I have logged into my Windows 10 system. I will go to this PC, C drive. I will go to users. These are all the users which are created in my system. I will close this. I will again go to run and I will type here appwise.cpl. These are all the softwares installed in my system. I will go to view installed updates. These are all the patches installed in my Windows 10 system. I will close this. You can see here I have renamed my C drive as Windows and I have renamed my D drive as data. I will go to D drive. and I will make one new folder here, and I will give the name scratch. This would be used as this would be used temporarily during the creation of the install.wm file. I will close this. I will again go to this PC. You can see here I have also connected the Windows 10 bootable pen drive to the system. I will now reboot my system and I will boot it through the bootable pen drive which I have connected to my system. I will restart my system. I will press F12 to interrupt the boot process and to go to boot manager. I will go to my USB drive and I will hit enter. I will press any key to boot from the USB. At this stage, you have to press the Shift plus F10 to open the command prompt. I will maximize this. I will type the disk part. Now I will type the list volume. You can see here the letter for the Windows drive is F and the letter for the data drive is E. I will type exit and press enter. Now I will type the command DISM space slash capture image. Slash image file colon. E colon / install.wim space. During this step, install.wim file will be created. After this, I will give the space and / capture dir colon F colon. Backslash, which means complete Windows drive would be captured and install.wm file would be created. After this, I will give the space / scratch dir colon E colon / scratch space. / name colon. I will give the ISO name. This is not important here. It will be actually used in next step while creating the ISO. After this, I will give the space / compress colon maximum. Space / check integrity. Space verify स्पेस बूटेबल, दिस इज द लोकेशन ऑफ इंस्टॉल डॉट डब्ल्यू एम फाइल विच वुड बी क्रिएटेड एंड दिस इज द विंडोज डायरेक्टरी विच वुड बी कैप्चर्ड एंड दिस इज द स्क्रैच फाइल लोकेशन फोल्डर लोकेशन विच वुड बी यूज टेम्पररली. I will hit enter and it will start saving the image. Install.wim image is about to complete. Operation has completed successfully and image has been saved. I will close the command prompt and I will close this window also, yes, which will cancel the installation process and it will boot my system normally through the OS. System has booted and OS screen is there. I will provide the password for my username to log in to the Windows. I have successfully logged in to my Windows. I will go to this PC. I will go to D drive and this is the install.wim file which was created in previous step. And it is the scratch folder which was temporarily used. I will close this. I will again go to this PC. I will go to D drive and I will make the new folder here with the name my underscore files. I will go back to this PC. I will go to E drive and this is the Windows 10 ISO. I will right click and mount it. I will go back to this PC. I will open the mounted ISO and I will select all and I will copy the all content. I will go to this PC, I will go to D drive, I will go to my underscore files folder and I will paste the content copied here. I will go to D drive and I will cut the install.wim file. I will go to my files, sources and I will paste here. One install.wim file is already present here, so it will ask me to replace. I will go ahead and confirm the replace of the file. I will open the browser, I will go to google.com and I will search the Windows 10 assessment and deployment kit. I will open this link and I will download this ADK setup for the Windows 10 version 2004. I will open the folder, I will right click on the ADK setup and I will do the run as administrator. Next, next, accept. I will untick the all other options here and I will keep the tick only on deployment tools. I will click on install and I will complete the installation of the ADK. ADK setup has been installed. I will go to start and I will search here deployment and imaging tool. I will right click and run as administrator to open it. Here I will type the cd / to go to C drive directly. Here I will give this command. This is the my underscore files folder path, and this would be the Windows 10 ISO name which is going to be created in this step. I will copy the complete command. And I will paste here and I will hit the enter. Windows 10 ISO creation is in progress. All the commands used in this video I will provide in the description. Once this step is completed, we will get the Windows 10 ISO. The final ISO. Windows 10 ISO creation has completed here. I will go to this PC. I will go to D drive. And this is the Windows 10 ISO which is created in this step. This is my main system having the VMware workstation installed. And this is the Windows 10 ISO file which I have copied, created in the last step. And on the VMware workstation I have created this virtual machine with the 20 GB hard disk. I will go to edit setting of the virtual machine. I will go to CDDB drive and I will mount the ISO which I had copied. Okay. I will power on the virtual machine. It will start the operating system installation from the ISO. Next, install now. Accept. Next, custom. New. Apply. Okay. Next. It has started the operating system installation from the ISO which we had connected to the CDDVD drive. It is restarting here to complete the installation. After the restart, it will boot directly to the operating system. Here you can see our virtual machine has successfully booted to the operating system which is having the pre-installed softwares and pre-created users. I will give the password for my username. I have successfully logged in to the virtual machine to which we have just installed the operating system through the ISO. I will go to start and I will go to run. I will enter on the run. I will type here appwise.cpl. I will click OK. These are all the pre-installed software from my original system which got installed in this virtual machine through the ISO. I will close this. I will go to this PC. I will right click on the ISO and eject this. I will go to C drive. I will go to users. These are all the pre-created users from my original system. I will close this. By this way, you can create the bootable ISO from the any Windows system, whether it is Windows 10, Windows 8, Windows Server 2016 or Windows Server 2019. Procedure would be the same. Share this video with your friends and spread the knowledge. Like this video, subscribe to channel. I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.